we're going to spend a little bit of time learning how to name coordination compounds. Well, as in the case of any salt, the name of the cation is given before the name of the anion. So, for example, we've got here this this structure in which the anion is a complex and the cation is well, the sodium ion, and you know the name of the cation goes first. The ligands are named before mentioning the metal, and they are named in alphabetical order. So you've got the alphabetical order of the ligands, and then the metal. So we've got here this example in which the complex, the ion, goes first because it's a cation, and this this cobalt complex ion has 5 ammonia and 2 chloride anions. So we mention first the ammonia anions and the ammonia ligands, and then the chloride ligand. And as you can see, they have specific names, and I will cover that in a subsequent slide. Then you mention the metal, cobalt, and then you mention the oxidation state, in this case 3, and finally you put the anion, which is case chloride. So ligands in alphabetical order, metal, and oxidation state of the metal. The names of the ligand are based on the name of the molecule or ion, but there are some changes. When the ligand is an anion, it tends to end in the letter O. So for example, the bromide anion, when the bromide anion is in a complex, you call that anion bromo. A chloride anion, chloro. Cyanide, cyano. When it's a neutral ligand, you usually keep the name of the molecule. For example, ethylene diamine, when using that ligand in a compound and you're naming that compound that contains that ligand, still keeps the name ethylene diamine. Pyridine. Water molecules are called aqua, sort of Latin name. Ammonia, another common one, is called amine. And carbon monoxide, when you have the CO, you call that the carbonyl. So you can kind of recognize the names from the original name of the ligand, but they are, as you can see, there are some, you know, some changes to the ending, especially when you're looking at anionic ligands. When you want to indicate the number of each type of the ligand in a molecule, where there are more than one of one type, you use the Greek prefixes di, tri, tetra, penta, hexa, etc. If the ligand itself already has a Greek prefix, or if you are looking at a polydentate ligand, then instead of di, tri, tetra, you use bis, tris, tetrakis, and the name of the ligand is put in parentheses. So for example, here you have a cobalt compound in which a cobalt complex in which the cobalt is attached to ethylene diamine, and 3 molecules of ethylene diamine, so 3 ligands, and it is the cation part of that this is an ionic compound, is the cation part, so it goes first. So you use tris because this is a polydentate anion, ethylene diamine, and you put the ethylene diamine in brackets, and you use tris instead of tri because it's a polydentate ligand. If the complex is an anion, the complex part, if the in the ionic compound the complex is an anion, then you end the name with an 8. And finally, for example, here you've got a molybdate, because this is an anion part, and it's the sodium, the positive, you know, the cation part is the sodium ions. And finally, you put the, in brackets, the oxidation state of the metal and the complex using Roman numerals. So in this case, this compound, well, it's a sodium salt, the molybdate has an oxygen and four chloride anions. So chloride has the name chloro, oxygen has the name oxo, so it would be tetrachloro because there are four chloride anions, oxo, molybdate because it's an anion, and four because that's going to be the oxidation state of the of molybdenum in that particular compound. And if you have a look at the oxidation state of the sodium, the oxygen and the chloride, you will work out that that's the correct oxidation state. So let's have a little practice. I'm going to ask you to stop the video and have a go at naming these two complexes by using the rules I mentioned before. Stop the video now, please. So how would I go about naming these compounds? So the first one, I've got four molecules of water, and water is aqua, so that's going to be a tetraaqua, and two chlorides in part of the coordination sphere. I'm referring to these ones here, and that those are chloros, so dichloro. Aqua will go first, so this will be a tetraaqua dichlorochromium chloride. And why three? Well, if I add up, sure, this should be an equal here, not equal zero. If I add up all these oxidation states of all the atoms in the compound, you know, water will have an oxidation state of zero, a neutral molecule. The chlorides have an oxidation state of minus one. That gives me that the chromium needs to be in an oxidation state of three for that compound to be, you know, to exist. For the second one, I noticed that the first atom, well, the is actually a potassium atom, and the brackets, the coordinate, the complex metal ion is therefore an anion. So I know I'm going to have to change the ending to 8. So it won't be nickel, it will be a nickelate. And it has four cyanides, so it will be tetracyanide. And I will put the potassium first, then the tetracyanide, then nickelate, because it's an anion. And if I work out the oxidation states of all these compounds, I can see that nickel is an oxidation, interestingly, in nominally in an oxidation state zero. So I wouldn't put anything in the brackets.